Hello dear students. So in the previous lessons we discussed the electron microscope, its basic structure, and then the transmission electron microscope and staining which is required to prepare the samples for transmission electron microscope. Now we will look at some basic points of scanning electron microscope. So scanning electron microscope is a type of electron microscope that produces the images of a sample by scanning the surface with the focus of beam of electrons. So here also the source of light is the electron beam, just like the transmission electron microscope. So it is also known as SEM. This allows the researchers to examine much bigger variety of specimens, and again it helps them to look into the structure of the specimens. Even they can look at the 3D structure of the specimens. The electrons interact with the atoms in the sample and they produce various signals that contain the information about the surface topography and the composition of the sample. So, what does this mean? This means that you can obtain a 3D structure of the image by the electron microscopy. And these specimens are also in 3D structure, and the beams of electrons that strike these structures, that strike the different surfaces of the specimen, they can produce the image in terms of the refracted beam of electrons. The specimens can be observed in high vacuum in the conventional SEM, or in the low vacuum, or even in the wet conditions in a variable pressure or the environmental SEM, at the wide range of cryogenic or elevated temperatures with the specialized instruments, meaning you can observe several different types of specimens by the help of this microscope. Okay, so how does this work and what is the light path in case of scanning electron microscope? Just like the transmission electron microscope, there is an electron gun which is provided with the tungsten filaments that produces the electron beams with the high voltage. And that beam produces the light rays that fall on the magnetic lens. But in case of the SEM, it is different in a way that there is an anode between the magnetic lens or the condenser and the electron gun. So what is the function of this anode? This is used to converge the electron beam and prevent its scattering. ओके ताकि ये स्कैटर ना करे, इसलिए एनोड को यूज़ किया जाता है, क्योंकि इलेक्ट्रॉन बीम कैरीज द नेगेटिव चार्ज, whereas anode carries the positive charge, and in this way the anode can trap all of the electron beams and avoid their scattering or the unnecessary scattering. Okay, it will fall on the condenser lenses will move it forward, okay, and make it fall on the specimen or the scanning coils, from which it falls on the electron detectors that detect it. And from here they fall on the stage, okay, and then there's a prism present over here that gives the image also to the eyepiece and the secondary electron detector which collects the image to the TV scanner or the computer screen. Okay, so you can see that the electron beam is following a vertical path within the microscope, and all of these structures are held within the vacuum as it was in the transmission electron microscope. So the beam will travel through the electromagnetic lenses and the electromagnetic field, and this will help to focus the beam down towards the sample. Once the beam will hit the sample, the electrons and the X-rays are ejected from the sample and they are detected by the help of the detectors, as you can see here. So what are the general advantages of scanning electron microscopy? The scanning electron microscope has many advantages over the traditional microscopes because it has a large depth of field. It allows more of the specimen to come into focus at one time as compared to the other microscopes. SEM has also got much higher resolution as compared to the light microscope because it is using electrons as the beam of light and the electromagnetic lenses to converge these light beams. Therefore, the closely placed specimens can be magnified at much higher levels. Because the scanning electron microscope uses the electromagnets rather than the conventional lenses that are made up of the glass material, that's why the researcher has got much more control in the degree of magnification, okay? Meaning the angle of light can be controlled over here, and the magnified image is not only magnified, rather it has also got a better resolution. And therefore it provides strikingly clear image that makes the scanning electron microscopy as one of the most useful instruments in research today. And as we mentioned in the beginning, it can help you to provide the 3D image of the object that is under study. That's all for the moment. Thank you.